Good morning, children. Welcome back to our Google Classroom. Today, we can discuss the topic Modal Auxiliaries. Our Ramya ma'am has already introduced this topic. Today, we can learn this in detail. What are verbs? What do you mean by verbs? What are verbs? The word which expresses what the subject owns or possesses, what the subject is or the condition of the subject, and what the subject does are called verbs. We learned that verbs are divided into two. Which are they? Main verbs and auxiliary verbs. Which are the main verbs? Mostly the action words are the main verbs. Then auxiliary verbs. Auxiliary verbs are divided into two. Modal auxiliaries and primary auxiliaries. Which are the primary auxiliaries? Forms of be, do and have are the primary auxiliaries. Then modal auxiliaries. Which are the modal auxiliaries? Will, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might, must, ought to, dare, need and used to are called modal auxiliaries. Why they are called modal auxiliaries? Because they indicate the mood or the state of mind of the speaker. It also indicates possibility, permission, duty, etc. These verbs are used along with the main verbs. For example, they will come tomorrow. They will come tomorrow. Here, we used the modal auxiliary will with the main verb come. Let's learn the usage of modal auxiliaries in detail. Will. We use will to talk about the future. For example, it will rain tomorrow. It will rain tomorrow. I will go in the evening. I will go in the evening. We use will to show determination. For example, I'll do my level best to win the badminton championship. Or, I will complete the homework today itself. I'll complete the homework today itself. We use will to make promises and offers. I'll give you my pen. I'll give you my pen. It is an offer. We will replace the faulty water purifier at no extra cost. The negative form of will not, and it is contracted as want. Shall. We use shall with I and we to make suggestions. Shall we go to Pune this weekend? Or shall we visit our grandparents tomorrow? The negative form of shall is shall not, and it is contracted as shan't. Can. We use can to talk about someone's abilities. I can swim. Manju can speak French and Tamil fluently. We use can to ask for permission informally. Can I watch the television for half an hour? The negative form of can is cannot, and it is contracted as can't. Could. We use could to ask for permission. For example, could I use your phone for a minute? Or could I use your pen? Could is more polite than can. We use could to politely ask or tell someone something. For example, could you help me to get a book? We use could to talk about someone's abilities in the past. For example, Leela could paint when she was 3 years old. Or, I could climb tree when I was 10 years old. That means now that persons are not able to do that. It is only past ability. The negative form of could is could not. It is contracted as couldn't. May. We use may to formally ask for permission. For example, may I come in? May I leave now? It is formal. We use may in formal situations. We use may to talk about possibilities. For example, they may come back. Or it may rain now. We learned that we use may, could and can to ask questions. But may and could are more polite and formal. At the same time, can is used generally to ask something informally. The negative form of may is may not. It is not contracted. Might. We use might to talk about possibilities. For example, it might rain later. The negative form of might is might not. And it is not contracted. We can use may and might interchangeably to talk about the possibility in the future, although might suggest less certainty of something happening than may. That means might suggest less possibility than may. We can discuss the rest of the modal auxiliaries in the next class. That's all for today. A YouTube URL is attached. Watch the video. The notes of this topic is also attached. Learn it. A test paper is also included. Submit your answers as soon as possible. We can meet in the next class with the continuation of this topic. Thank you.